Do you have an audio interface and would like to upgrade to a new one without losing all the functionality and the inputs of the first one? Well, in this video, I'll show you exactly how to use two or more audio interfaces at the same time on Mac and how to get set up in no time. Let's get going. I received many comments and questions following the last video I uploaded regarding how to optimize your Mac for audio production, which you can see right there. As I explained in that video, my current studio setup uses two audio interfaces at the same time. And the reason for that is that the first audio interface that I bought, that is now discontinued, was an SSL MIDI Extreme, along with an SSL MIDI AlphaLink AX with 24 analog inputs to record a full drum set. And after that, I needed to upgrade to be able to travel something portable. So I purchased an Apollo 20X, that's Thunderbolt 3. So during that whole trip, I was working with the Apollo 20X, and I loved the mix console from UAD and the fact that I had no latency when recording. So I decided to come back and still use that Apollo 20X interface, but I was missing some inputs, some analog inputs specifically for reamping. So when I came back, I had to find a way to make both work at the same time. And I found a way by creating an aggregate audio device in Mac OS, and I'll show you exactly how that works. So to be able to create an audio aggregate device, you're gonna first go in Finder, Applications, Utilities, and then in Utilities, you're gonna find Audio MIDI Setup. So here in Audio Devices, you should be able to see everything that's plugged into your computer, plus your internal stuff like built-in microphone, built-in outputs. Here you see extra stuff, it's drivers that I installed for screen capture, black hole and telestream. If you don't see one of the interfaces that's plugged into your computer, that means there may be an issue with the driver. So first thing you need to do is go check your Mac OS version and go on the manufacturer website and download the drivers, the latest ones for your audio interfaces. Sometimes if you don't have the driver installed, the computer won't even recognize the device. So you need to install that first and then go back to audio devices. Once that's done, you're gonna be able to see your devices there. And the next thing we're gonna do is go here and click on Create Aggregate Device, okay? So here on the left menu, you can select as many as you want, and this will create basically a combination of all the devices in one aggregate unit. So here I'm gonna select MIDI Face USB and Universal Audio. So you see as I click here, inputs and outputs are appearing. And on top here, you can see clock source. So this is gonna be very important. In my case, the clock source will be my main interface, which is the Universal Audio. And the sample rate has to be the same on both interfaces. So also make sure that if you have buttons to press on, like here, my SSL device here, I need to make sure that I press the right option. If you want to make sure it's a bit clearer here, inputs and outputs, click on this button here, and then you're gonna be able to see vertically all the inputs and outputs, okay? So that's very important. And if you scroll down, you should be able to see all the inputs. So for example, here, channel 65 is gonna be my line input one on my Apollo 20X. Once the audio aggregate device is created, make sure you rename it so you know exactly what you're selecting when you're gonna open your DAW. So for example, here, I'm gonna call it UAD and SSL. Now we're gonna have to make sure of five things before we open the DAW of your choice. In my case, I'm using Cubase. First thing, make sure all the interfaces that you're using in your audio aggregate devices are connected to the computer. Second step, make sure all the drivers regarding each device are updated to the latest version. Third, make sure you quit all applications, because if you're running other software, let's say I'm running Final Cut at the same time as Cubase, there may be issues with sample rate because Final Cut usually runs at 48 kilohertz, while my projects in Cubase are running at 44.1 kilohertz. So this may create issues as well. Number four, make sure that all your interfaces are set at the same sample rate. And when you open a new project in your DAW, make sure it's a matching sample rate. So again, 44.1 kilohertz. So now let's go in our DAW to make sure that the audio aggregate device is functioning properly. So here I have Cubase. I will go in Studio Setup. here in the left upper corner, you have audio system, and here in ASIO driver, make sure that your new audio aggregate device is selected, and then you're gonna click switch, and then okay. And then after that, we're gonna have to assign inputs and outputs. So we're gonna go in audio connections. So if your outputs are not assigned yet, so for example here, monitor left and right, make sure that they're assigned. And inputs, in this case, you add as many as you want. It can be, for example, 40 stereo inputs. So you're gonna see here all the default channels. You can see here MIDI, and here you can see all my UAD channels, okay? So this, you can change them as you want, but at least it's clear, okay? Here we can add as well all my other inputs and outputs. So by default, Cubase will map the right device port with the stereo channels here, you can see. The last two things to make sure everything works fine is to first, for example, import one song you're very familiar with and play back in your DAW. So if there's an issue with the sample rate, you're gonna hear it right away. Sometimes if the setup is not well done, if you forgot one little thing here or there, there may be issues with the sample rate. So that's one way to check. And the second would be to double check your routing matrix, your inputs and outputs. So for example, you can record a vocal signal, you can try to reamp guitars. So that way you're gonna make sure that it's coming in and out the right way. I hope that you found this content helpful. If you did, please click like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so that I can bring more good stuff to you. Cheers, and see you very soon.